Dear brothers and sisters, in this time of emergency, due to the coronavirus, the dispute between progressives and conservatives among Catholics on how the church should react to the pandemic is growing more and more. In fact, while conservatives accuse progressives of lack of faith and are accused in turn of being fideist, we normal Christians, that is free from any extremisms except that of love, enlightened by the doctrine of the right autonomy of earthly affairs, thought by the Second Vatican Council, we are grateful and support scientists, researchers, experts, and visionaries who see in some way the future in advance with their intuitions, discoveries, and innovations can contribute to the progress of the world, helping it to be more human, more fraternal, and solidary. On the other hand, however, we Christians are aware, like the man born blind, of whom we will listen the beautiful story told by the Apostle and Evangelist John on Sunday, Mark 22nd, to which Jesus gave back with the sight of the eyes, also the super view, so to speak, of the faith, that no human progress can fully respond to the needs of our being created in the image and likeness of God. Moreover, we clearly see the abyss that separates leaders of this world, no matter how visionaries they are, from Jesus of Nazareth, whom we believe, profess, and announce to be the only savior of the humankind. In fact, dear brothers and sisters, the incredible and joyful good news that the church has been announcing for 2,000 years is that Jesus, true God and true man, possesses not only a sure vision of the future, but he himself is the future in person, the absolute future of every man and woman of the whole human history, the future towards which the whole creation is oriented. In fact, Jesus is the eternity that breaks into time, especially in man's history, in order to recapitulate it and bring it to the fulfillment according to the eternal plan of God the Father. Dear brothers and sisters, it's over now. Ciao, and God bless you always.